outlying areas are especially hard hit. Whole communities in the stricken sections are now completely inundated, and the watershed systems taxed beyond their capacity.
Check your pressure graph.
890 over 66.
We're nearing another cloud area below the cosmic dust blanket.
Reports are impossible to obtain, but we do know that high winds are accompanying the heavy downpour in some areas, and that the torrential rains are continuing in an ever-increasing pattern, adding to the widespread damage. Is estimated in the billions. Relief facilities are totally inadequate to meet the gigantic task at hand, and there's no sign of any let-up. We will continue this...
Commando Cody to radar control. Are you still following that unidentified ship?
Yes, sir. It's holding steady on course 265, now about 20,000 feet above the cosmic dust blanket.
What's its latest position?
Now over coordinates 176 north, 432 west.
Thanks. Call me when you make the next fix.
Very well, sir.
Here's the course that ship's been following. All along its route, there have been explosions in the clouds, followed by cloudbursts a few minutes later.
You mean that strange ship is causing the rains?
It could be, Joan. Our own scientists seed the clouds to make rain. Someone from another planet could be doing it to flood the Earth.
Well, I'm a little new around here, but... judging by what Ted told me before he was transferred, this sounds just like your old pal, the ruler.
I'm afraid you're right, Dick. How many more?
Three. Then we're to wait for Earth's answer to the ruler's ultimatum.
Ship has changed course for your city. Should be over you in about an hour. Altitude 80,000.
Say, we've got time enough to get the rocket ship up to intercept it.
They have radar too, Dick. They'd spot us and get away before we could reach them. But their radar won't pick me up in my flight jacket.
You can't intercept a rocket in that.
No, but as long as they're so high, I'll have time to see if they really are dropping something in the clouds. Then we'll know what we're up against.
We'll radio you the fixes as they come in.
Fine.
Just a minute, I better check the dispeller attachment.
Good thought. I'd hate to get in the cosmic dust blanket if it wasn't working.
Check and double check.
Hmm.
position as of 14-06 was 212 north, 318 west.
212-318. That puts it right here.
Calling Commander Cody.
Calling Commander Cody. Come in, Dick.
The rocket's in a 175-degree course. From the last report, it should pass 3 miles west of you in about 4 or 5 minutes.
Good, there she is now. It's one of the ruler's ships, all right.
Is this the last one?
Yes. Unless we're ordered to drop more.
So small a bomb caused so much damage.
Because of the gas, it's so highly concentrated. Hello, Mr. Henderson. Any news?
Yes. Here's a message just radioed in from the ruler. The Security Commission wants us to handle it. To the nations of the world, I am stopping the floods to give you time to consider my ultimatum. I demand that you disperse the cosmic dust blanket around Earth and allow my rocket transports to land our occupation forces. I will accept only unconditional surrender. Unless you accept these terms within 24 hours, your entire civilization will be swept into the sea. Radio your reply on shortwave band 2012, and it will be relayed to me by my representatives on Earth. Signed, the ruler.
Were they able to locate the station that sent the message?
No, it must have been sent in a moving transmitter, probably in a car.
But it's fantastic. Can the ruler really cause a flood like that?
I'm afraid so. This bomb is loaded with a radioactive gas, which is released when it explodes. And then when the gas mixes with the water vapor in the clouds, they turn into rain.
What can we do about it?
There's a neutralizer for any chemical reaction if there's time to work it out.
But we only have 24 hours.
Maybe we can stretch it a little. Tell the ruler that it may take several days to contact the governments of all nations. Say that our communication lines have been flooded out.
Yeah, it might work.
This is Commissioner Henderson calling the ruler's representative. The ruler's ultimatum has been received, but due to flood damage of our communication system, it'll be impossible to consult all the nations in the time limit set. We request at least 4 days to prepare our answer. I repeat, this is Commissioner Henderson calling the ruler's representative.
Baylor reporting from Earth.
Take that.
This is Baylor reporting from Earth. Henderson has received your ultimatum. He says he'll need 4 days to contact the other nations before he can draft his reply.
That is too long. They are maneuvering for time.
Tell them I must have their reply in 2 days at the latest. And be sure all they are doing is preparing an answer. That is all.
How are we going to find out what they're doing?
The only way I know of is to keep a check on Cody. Take your car and radio Henderson, then come back here. By that time, I'll figure out a way to spy on Mr. Sky Marshal.
Be right back.
Yes? Yes, Mr. Henderson, I'll tell them. They've received the ruler's ultimatum. He wants his answer in 2 days.
We've analyzed the gas that causes the rain.
Yes, but working out a formula to stop those bombs is something else again.
We've got to do it. We'll work around the clock until it's done.
Well, that I'll buy.
Let's have at it.
This vocaceptor will pick up sounds through the walls of any building. Give it to old Chris, the apple peddler. They're used to seeing him around. Tell him to get as close as he can to Commando's office and tune it in on the building.
Right.
Mr. Mike?
Chris has made contact.
I see. Thanks.
The counter gas is on its way to the rocket now, Commando.
Good. That covers everything. The dispenser is already installed.
How long will it take to spread the gas?
Only a few hours. We'll spread it along a north and south line between these points.
The rotation of the Earth will scatter it through the rest of the cosmic dust blanket. Then the ruler's rain-making bombs will explode before they hit the clouds.
Can you finish the job in time?
Well, we can try.
This is Baylor reporting from Earth.
I've just learned that Commando Cody has worked out a counter gas to explode your bombs before they reach the clouds. You'll try to have it in place before your ultimatum expires.
I'll teach them what it costs to try to play tricks on me. What they've had so far is only a small sample of what they're going to get. Calling rocket R6.
Calling rocket R6.
This is R6. We read you, Excellency.
What is your position?
Cruising halfway between Earth and Moon.
Proceed at once to east part of the United States. Drop a series of delayed action bombs into the heavy clouds over that area.
But, Your Excellency, that'll wash half the country away.
That's what I want.
When you are finished there, we'll give Europe the same treatment. That is all.
Enough left of the world to conquer. But orders are orders. Course 93.
Course 93.
Calling
calling post number one. Calling post number one.
Post number one.
This is Commando Cody. We're entering the rocket area. Clear us with the other post.
Yes, sir. Calling post number two. Calling post number two.
Order, Commander. Good. We're taking off right away.
Yes, sir.
Fire pilot jet.
Fire pilot jet.
Fire main jets.
Fire main jets.
Reports an unidentified ship moving in for the moon toward the east coast. That area isn't covered by the gas blanket yet.
How soon will it be covered?
Several hours. We're almost through laying the gas, but it's just begun to spread. Should we try to intercept that rocket?
No. No, you better finish dispensing the counter gas. I'll keep you informed on all radar contacts.
Very well, sir. Give her all she'll take, Dick. We've got to get through this job in a hurry.
Full speed. Plus.
End of plot line, Commando.
That does it, Dick. Head east.
East it is.
Calling Commander Cody. Calling Commander Cody.
Yes, Mr. Anderson.
Radar reports the enemy rocket now nearing the eastern seaboard, vicinity of New York. Is there any chance the gas blanket has reached that far yet?
No chance at all. But we've finished spreading the gas, and we'll try to intercept the rocket.
Hope you make it.
Course for New York is 9-3.
9-3. Radar can fix the course of that rocket this soon. It'll be over its target before we can get there.
Yes, but we may be able to knock it down before it does much damage.
Almost over the target area. Target.
Thank you. target.
Over New York. There are reports of a tidal wave moving in. What's the last radar fix on the enemy ship? Flying due north from the center of the storm area. Now about over central New Hampshire. We'll make contact with him in about 2 minutes.
Make it as fast as you can or the entire eastern seaboard will be wiped out.
Yes, sir. Generator.
There's a ship coming up on our quarter. I'll use the gun.
Stand by for ray gun fire.
Standing by.
Left 15.
Left 15.
Elevate 12.
Elevate 12.
On target, steady.
Steady she is.
Keep firing!
He isn't hurting us any more than we did him.
But he's too far away for burst firing. I'm going to put a steady ray on. Right 10.
Right 10.
On target, hold her steady.
Steady. Continuous ray on us.
It'll melt the ship. Fire again.
Thank you.
next, Commander?
Set a course for the storm area.
That'll be about 118.
Counter gas is working.
Good. Now the storm will clear.
It's about time.
You can say that again.
It's about time.
Head for home, Dick.
Yes, sir.
Have you a final estimate of the damage?
No, but it might have been much worse. Fortunately, the counter gas kept the destruction localized.
Well, at least there's one satisfaction. There'll be no more floods.
Can we count on that, Commando?
Well, I think so, Dick.
Oh, that's what I call good news. Boy, have I been uncomfortable.
Oh!